because I do not like to think of the idea of them becoming, you know how we talk about teachers teaching to test? And so we don't want to become leaders and staff so focused on the strategic plan that we don't see other things that have come into our arena, if you will. It's always an important document, it's an important thing to do, and it helps us focus centrally, but it doesn't become the only thing we do.
You don't want to stifle innovation.
Or a new crisis, or a new issue, or something comes up that, well, I'm sorry, that doesn't come up until the next time we update the strategic plan. That doesn't work in education, and I don't think it would work here, so it's just a comment. Councilmember Curdman.
Mayor, I'd like to make a motion that City Council approve the City of Maplewood teacher plan.
Second. It's been moved by Cardinal and seconded by Juneman to pass the strategic plan. Is there any discussion? So I have some discussion. I just wanted to bring up one page in there that I'd be interested in for the retreat moves and City Manager Coleman. We talked about this today, which is page 70, which was the strengths finder, is as the council changes and if there's any staff changes or whatever happens, that we can incorporate the new folks into this and then maybe spend a little bit more time on that, because I felt like we didn't get the, you know, I go places where people will say, yeah, we operate off our strengths finders and we know the team, this person does that, and you know, we know that you know, you all are the management team and you're making the big money and you guys make the big decisions and then we just come in and make the policy decisions and try to make sure things are
we make the big money, you miss it.
And so we don't want to in any way imply that, you know, there's still that policy, the difference in our roles, however, how those roles could complement each other. And maybe spend, I don't know, we talked about maybe there's a person we could bring in for an hour or more or something, and to sort of be more consistent with that, because some people and other organizations really use those, and it's helpful. You know.
Thank you for that comment, Mayor. I think that's really good. And I just was noticing that when I go meet with other city managers or other cities, that some of the people that have been used the strength finder, they actually have it displayed in their office. As a superintendent, our new superintendent of the schools had it on her desk.
Yeah.
And I thought, looking to see which characteristics she had. So I think I think it could be a key piece in the strategic planning process for next year. So I thank you for that comment.
Hey, you're welcome. And I think really just to help each other, we understand each other better. So thank you. Otherwise, I thought it was very well done. Mr. Funk, thanks for all your work on this. I know it was a little unwieldy at times, and we do want to keep it flexible, and it's kind of a working document. So there's a motion on the table. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Hearing ayes all, the strategic plan is passed. And that brings us to the end of new business, so there's no more to visit. So we're going to do visitor presentations. I'm not going to read the whole mayor's address on protocol before, but part of it is at the podium, please state your name and address clearly for the record. All comments, questions should be posed to the mayor and council. The mayor, lender, and staff is appropriate to answer questions or respond to comments. And City Manager Coleman, we always said that we have a part about being respectful in the process, keeping order and decorum. Do not be critical of council members, staff, or others in public. Be respectful of each other's time, keeping remarks brief to the point and non-repetitive. So that's another part of the rules of civility. Before we get started, do we have any visitors, Ms. Hay?
Yes, Mayor. John Wyckoff, please.
Mr. Wyckoff, can you state your name and address for the record? Welcome to Maplewood City Council.
John Wyckoff, 2345 Maryland Avenue East in Maplewood. And today, I was pretty much in shock today when I hear all these new murder reports coming to me and hearing about the number of violence and law breaking and crimes that are happening in Maplewood. When I was a young child living in St. Paul, it was my dream to live in Maplewood. I thought it was a first class city. I thought it was a great place to live. But after living here since 1990, I've decided, and you probably noticed, I have a sign that says for sale on my property. I have found a much better place to live, and the people seem to